Whenever I see new rookie groups, I like watching their songs and concepts, but aside from enjoying the music, it always comes to my mind that they look very young, or maybe that's because I'm getting old. I am a second generation fan, and back then, I didn't really think about it, but many idols start their careers at a really young age, and in many cases, they are underage. Being an idol is a special type of career, we all know about it. But the truth is that making a debut at such a young age will inevitably have its downsides. And we know that there are laws that protect to some extent these young idols, but nonetheless, they still have a lot of things to endure. And I think not many people talk about this. So how about we watch the problems with underage idols? But first, a disclaimer. Some of the topics in this video are controversial, and as such, this is only one point of view, and in no sense I am saying that the things discussed are the reality. I could be missing a lot more information. Still, feel free to comment down below what you think of underage idols in the industry. And if I'm missing a point, you can always tell me in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos. It helps me a lot to keep doing them. Being an idol is already a difficult path, with all the training and the low probability of hitting it big if you are not part of the biggest companies. Still, to this, we have to add the several hardships they endure because of their age. Even if they debut and gain instant popularity and recognition, in the end, we have to remember that they are still kids. At that age, many of us are actually still getting to know ourselves, and it is also time to learn from your mistakes, or to establish your self-esteem. And now, imagine having controversies like the one Chewy had when she was only 16 years old, and was made to apologize publicly for something she didn't really have the control over, or getting criticism or hate comments like Somi while she was in a competition show and after it. And it is expected that all this hate and criticism will have a big impact on them. Some idols have said that during their debut or rookie years, they were actually really naive and had several drawbacks in that time, like Temi. At the end, they also have to survive in an environment that asks them to follow certain Korean beauty standards, diet, behave perfectly, and in summary, not make mistakes. I'm no expert in psychology, nor I'll say that all underage idols suffer mentally, but the pressure idols have to go through is bound to affect them, and I'll say underage idols are more vulnerable to it. The next point we have to discuss is exploitation of underage idols. As I said before, there are at least some laws that protect these idols. In particular, they are not allowed to work after 10 PM, and we have seen many examples of the companies following this rule. Like when ITZY and TXT left the awards show early, or when some members of NCT had to stop filming for a show. However, one will wonder if it is real enough. After all, this takes me to the next point. There seems to be a normalization of idols debuting at a really young age, and I don't know if that is okay. Underage idols have existed since the beginning of K-pop. At least I can remember quite a lot of them from older groups or as soloists, like IU, Sohyun, Crystal, Suzy, Hyuna, Taemin, and even BoA debuted when she was only 13. However, nowadays, I have also seen that some netizens and fans have certain expectations regarding the new groups. For example, in competition shows, I always see comments about certain participants being too old to be in the group. Or even, in the case of Treasure, there were some haters that didn't want a certain member to be part of the group for being too old, and he was only 19 at the time. It seems now people are not only accepting of idols being underage, but they are actually expecting it. And there are some netizens that seem to even prefer when idols are younger. And maybe this is something related to culture? There seems to be quite a big importance in the role of maknae and naegyo, for example. It is always required for idol groups to show an act of innocence, and for the younger ones in the group, they are bound to follow, at least to a certain extent, the stereotype of the maknae. I have talked about this before in the video of short idols, and this also applies to the youngest members. Forcing someone to act cute or do aegyo is not good. There have even been instances where the companies take unnecessary measures to keep an innocent or young image for their idols. One case was Jungkook of BTS, where it is known that for a time he was advised not to do too much exercise as to not develop that much muscle and stop looking a certain way. Of course, that is in the past, and probably Big Hit or HYBE gives them a lot more freedom now, and they are able to decide many things about their image. But that doesn't mean that it is not something that happens commonly with idols, and especially young idols. To this, we also have to mention the biggest problem with idols being underage, the the sexualization of young idols. I had previously talked about this topic in another video. You can see it right here. However, I haven't really gone deep into the subject. As many of you already know, it is normal for idols to have sexy concepts every now and then, and there are many people that like them, like me. However, this is not the same as to have underage idols not only performing or showing a sexy image, but in many cases, using it as an appeal or marketing strategy. JYP is known for doing this frequently, from putting Hyuna and Seohye as the centers in the group with a mature and alluring choreography, to later on Suzy in their debut with Missae when she was only 15 years old, to Chewy doing some uncomfortable looking ads when she was 16, and now Yuna of ITZY, using clothes that some fans consider not very appropriate for her age, especially when she was still underage. We can see the sexualization of underage idols everywhere. It is not only JYP or Mnet with their competition shows, but yeah, it was really disturbing what the producer said about Produce 101 at the time. At the end, we have to say that not only companies contribute to the sexualization of idols, it is also the fans that do it. There have been several mentions of fans writing sexual fanfics of their bias, who in some cases are underage. There are forums or comments in different social media about some idols that are definitely inappropriate. At the end, fans also objectify idols. But is this really part of their job? Do companies have the right of promoting a group a certain way because it will get them more attention? Or are fans responsible for the way these idols are promoted? There is also the option that idols themselves could like the way they are being portrayed, though questionable. For example, both Kai and Jimin said that they didn't like showing their abs too much or using crop tops, and they still had to do it. Crystal also had to show her abs in the choreography of new ABO, and she didn't really like it, but her fans said that it was alright and that she should keep on doing it. And we also have to say that sexualization of minors is not only a problem in K-pop, it happens everywhere. Other Asian countries, or America. This is a complicated situation that all parts involved have some responsibility over it. And the truth is that there will be no changes unless the entertainment industry itself decides to change, as well as consumers being more conscious of what they support. Underage idols is a situation that is not going to stop. While I understand that there are many people that like idols being younger, because maybe they feel more related to them if they are closer to their ages, it's also important to be aware of all the things they have to go through. Hope you liked the video, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more. Also, tell me down below which other topics you would like me to cover. Maybe the problem with the big companies? Or the problem with competition shows? Or also something about beauty? I enjoy reading all your comments and suggestions.